then if you want to head back to the stand, go ahead and climb back up in the stand.
All right.
What I'll do is when I get there, I'm going to drop some moose scent and some roe deer scent, and then I'm going to head back to the lodge real quick so that I can grab more scent suppressor.
All right. Hopefully,
if I get up here in the right spot, he should mosey his way up the hill right past the stand.
Cool.
But usually when you have one ranger, as you can see, you'll usually have several more that'll be around.
Right.
It's just kind of the nature of the critter, because, you know, they run in
heat. I see him.
See him?
Yep,
I'm going to keep rattling then. Keep his attention, and if you get your shot.
He's walking sideways, so I don't know, he may be too far away just yet.
Well, I'm going to...
Come on.
Basically, I'm going to, you know, move 3-4 feet, rattle a couple of times, creep up a couple of feet, rattle a couple of times, see if I can draw him up towards me, because I'm right out, directly out from you from the stand. I heard you shoot.
I hit him.
Yeah, it said fired at reindeers. That's generally a good sign.
I had to take the shot. He was right in my sights. Now, it might have got him in the side. I don't know yet. I don't know how to mark this. I know where he went.
All right, well, you just hang tough and stay right where you are. I'm going to come up to the stand, and then basically I'll have you point me in the correct direction. And then once you point me in the correct direction, I'll hold still, so when you get down, we'll be able to orient just like we did, you know, in the stand the other night.
Right.
All right, cool. Let's go collect him.
Yeah, he was... He was right... around here where these little trees are.
All right. Well, my tracking is pretty good, so if we've got tracks, I'll definitely spot him.
I think I'm seeing something up here. Hold on. Can't tell yet.
And I'll keep an eye open for grizzlies. Generally, with all this shooting, they'll be a long way off. Grizzlies are surprisingly... timid creatures.
I got something here. And it might be blood.
Yep. As a matter of fact, I see it's giving me a full dome. That means you definitely hit him. Because it wouldn't give me a full dome on your shot unless you hit him.
He went this way.
Now, did you see which way he ran when you hit him?
Yeah, he was zigzagging when he went.
But he did start out downhill, right?
Yeah.
Okay. A lot of times, you know, you hit them in the whatever direction they're facing, they'll spin or whatever, and so it can be a little bit deceptive, that very first track. So that's why I wanted to make sure that you saw which direction he ran.
He's bleeding a lot, too.
Yeah. I'm sure you smacked him good. It's a body shot, but it means that you probably hit him in the liver again.
Okay, I got the... Wait a minute.
I got his next one. It's right up here.
Oh, I see it. I see it now.
Yeah, like I say, with the level that my tracking's at, if you lose it, I'll definitely still get it. Oh, yeah, and he's on the run. Now, the fact that we don't have any more blood off of that track means that we won't have blood again until he's almost ready to die. Let's see here.
Yeah, I'm not seeing another track.
Yeah, he might have broke off through the woods here on the hillside. They, like I say, they like to go back the direction they came from. So, let me take a look up the hill here. Not seeing any tracks on the hillside of it, so he might have shifted a little on the downhill side. Or he might have, you know, gone just a little ways and expired.
Come on, dude, where are you?
I'll check the downhill side of it. Alright, here we go, over here.
Cool. Is that him, or is it just blood?
You hear the creaking?
Yep.
So we've got another reindeer out there somewhere, number one, and number two, we got a grizzly bear not too far from us. I could hear his footfall.
Oh, God. Where'd you go? Oh, there you are.
I don't know where he is, but the the reindeer is, like, practically on top of us. When you get up near me, go ahead and his track is right by me on the right side. I'm just going to rattle a little bit, because that may be him that we're hearing. But his track should literally be right there in front of you.
There, I got it now.
Sounds like he's up the hill to you, right? Boy, wherever it is close.
Mm-hmm. Here.
Boy, you can hear him. He's just a creaking away. In fact, sounds like we got two of them, one to one side of us and one in the opposite side of us. Yep. Right, literally in the direction that you're facing at the bottom edge of the hill is one. Right there, yep, that direction right there.
Wait a minute, I think I see something. I wonder if my scent's any... I might need to use my scent eliminator. Okay.
I'm gonna stay here out of sight where the wind is favorable and keep rattling, and you never know.
Yep.
Yeah, we have got... I think we're surrounded.
Does the name Custer mean anything to you? Robin Williams said.
I'm just going to keep on rattling and use free look. Because one way or another, I think we're about to have another close encounter.
Let's just hope it's of the...
He is, like, right on top of us, wherever the heck he is. Yeah, we've got that one that's ahead of you, and then I've got one behind me back here somewhere, too.
Jeez. Wait a minute. I hear him rattling around, but...
Yeah, he's really close. I'm just going to keep on rattling. Hopefully he'll give us a chuff or something that'll activate our hunter. Maybe we can tell where he's moved to.
I thought I...
The biggest problem, of course, is I don't have any scent suppression left, so...
Yeah, we keep getting distracted.
Yeah, he is close.
I still haven't gotten the one I dropped.
Yeah.
Oh, shoot.
I'm going to do some rattling here, just see if we can draw him towards us. The wind doing. So the wind is actually blowing behind us, so the wind is in our favor. Your guys' next tracks are right up the hill here in the direction I'm facing.
Okay. I might go looking for him. Why don't you keep on that one? See if I can't find this dude.
There's two tracks here. One is going to be his original ingoing, and one's going to be his new outgoing.
Okay. Rediscover previous trail? That's probably not it. That's a new trail. That little guy has eluded me. And it worries me because I'm afraid he's. Well, there's more tracks over here. It's probably the wrong one.
No, down over there, that's actually that's his tracks. If you get down over there, you'll pick up his track again. He may have turned around and ran back the way he came from, but that would be unusual.
Okay.
Yeah, that should be his track right there that you're on.
Okay.
Alright, so this is his original incoming track here, which means probably just ahead and left here is probably his
I found him.
previous trail. You found him?
I think it's him up here. Whoa.
Female moose?
Yep. Yeah, that's a log that looks an awful lot like a deer.
Alright, you go ahead and check it because I've got.
It's a
I'm
log that
gonna.
looks a lot like a deer. Ah, sure.
All right, well, I've got his trail again down here.
Okay. Boy, this has been a hard one to find.
Yep, some of them it's like that. Crap.
What?
Hang on a sec.
Got one? You got him. Was there more than one?
I just didn't feel like chasing him that far. Now we're going to find out if that was yours. Because your guys' track, I believe, is right here. Alright, so we've got two tracks right close to each other up here. So when you get up next to me, you'll be able to discern which one is his and which one is not.
Yeah,
Is
it's on
one
the
of these
right.
is the one on the right?
Yep.
Okay. Then I believe that I just finished off your fella here.
So he wasn't all the way dead.
Well, because I hit him, it'll give you a solid dome whether he was your animal or not. So that's why we got to determine whether he was your animal or not. Right here. I'm about to find out. There you go. He's yours. It's your. Wow! Holy key rice, dude.
What?
He's a 464.
How is that really big?
I'll just remind you that the biggest one that I took earlier that you told me was so much bigger than the one that was blah blah was a 319.
Holy gosh.
Okay. So this is 140 points bigger. And the nice thing is because you took the first shot, see, he was credited to you, so I'll why don't you come around on this side where I am?
Well, we should both get in this shot.
We will. Look at those horns. Oh, goodness me. He is just a monstrosity, dude. I had no idea.
Wow. No, it took both of us to take him down.
Yeah, I mean, I can barely lift him off the ground. And you saw the way I was able to pull up that pig?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. You want to pull out your weapon? There you go. I'm going to see if I can kind of adjust and make sure you're the stardest feature here. There we go. Got him.
Excellent.
Wow, dude. That right there is a champion animal. Not in the neighborhood of a champion animal. I mean a straight-up champion animal.
Wow.
Yeah. I don't think I've ever encountered one with a higher score.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, I know they get bigger than that. I know their scores can run bigger than that, but that's the biggest score I've ever personally seen.
Well, from the distance, I couldn't tell how big he was. I just...
Well, not only that, but it's kind of deceptive because their score is based on two things. How wide their horns are apart.
Yeah.
And then the number of points and all of that. And so, normally, for one scoring that high, his rack would have been a foot and a half wider. So, I mean, he was really mature.
Wow.
All right. Well, if you want to take yourself back up into the stand, I can run out and get my anti-smelly, or given the fact that we appear to have another one hanging right by us, I can start rattling, you know?
Well, let's see what go ahead and rattle, see what happens.
All right. Because there's one definitely in the neighborhood. But, yeah, that was an absolute monster. Bloody hell. Alright.
Okay.
You want to get prone. Trust me when I tell you, you want to get prone, brother.
Okay.
Because we got company of a less than positive sort.
Oh, I see him. Oh, shit. Should I get my...
Sorry, I don't mess around when it comes to grizzly bears. Let's go collect him.
Should I shoot him just to make sure?
No, he's dead.
Oh, okay. All right.
Like I say, when it comes to grizzlies, I don't mess around. I dropped him on the spot because I wasn't about to get tore up by another one. I can't believe that reindeer didn't run when I shot. You can still hear him clacking and cranking and carrying on.
Well, you need to get you a shot next to this guy.
Yep. This one, he was turning to come down the hill, then he turned back along the hill, and he had turned and started coming towards us again. But with my sound turned up, like I say, they've got a very, very distinctive tread. And I heard him. Now if I can just figure out where he is. But he dropped on the spot, so I know he's down. Just a matter of where he is up here. He was quite a ways out.
I was going to say, I saw him, but it was definitely in this direction.
Yep, there he is.
Yeah. Ooh, he's big.
Yeah, I wasn't messing around. We didn't want to tangle with him.
Jeez. Big old bear.
Yep, body, left lung, heart. Just like it should be. Instinct kill. Now you notice he scores at 22, which seems like a really tiny number when you see all these 700s and 900s and things from other animals, but it's like rabbits. You can get rabbits that score 1,960, so the actual size of the number Doesn't really matter.
I guess I don't quite get what all it all means, but.
He's a heavy one. I'm having trouble moving him.
He looks kind of funny that way.
Yeah, I'm gonna roll him over now.
Alright.
Ooh, he's a heavy one. I'm having trouble moving him. There we go. That's what I was after right there. There we go. And then I'm gonna let his head drop. I'm gonna move myself here, and I'm gonna move you to. Oh, I guess I can't move you. Why don't you come up just a little bit closer? There you go. So that way I can shift the shot here. Get us both in it. There we go. And I've gotta get his paw out of his nose though. There we go. Lift his head up and freeze in.
Cheese.
There we go. One gradually bear.
Excellente.
Alright. Now, I'm going back to camp before we get waylaid by another animal. If you want to head back up to the stand, I will meet you back. Otherwise, you can accompany me and we can go out together. It's whatever you want to do, man.
Oh, what time is it here?
I haven't the slightest idea, but time flies fast doing
it. Oh, I know. I'm gonna have to. It's almost 2:45 here.
Okay. It's worth our effort to actually take the time to walk back to the lodge before we log out.
Okay.
So we can just stand up and walk normally. We shouldn't have to worry about running into any more grazzlies.
Not after that.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm kind of tired. I've had been up since about 6.
Yeah, I was a dumbass and forgot to start up my, capture software before we started hunting. And so I wasn't able to record any of that stuff.
I got it.
Awesome.
Yep, I got it all.
I didn't realize you were recording.
Yep. And you behaved yourself.
Well, I don't think I did any cussing, did I?
No. Not that I heard. If... Yeah, there's going to be a lot of extra footage. I got it. I wasn't recording at first, but...
She was about to charge us.
Wow. She was just standing right there, like, showing the place. Well, actually, yep. She does.
If you had zoomed in on her, what you'd see is that she was opening and closing her mouth.
Yeah.
Almost like she was popping her jaws. She was making a threat display. And if we had continued moving forward, she'd come straight at us.
I wonder if she had a calf.
You know, I've never seen a calf in the game.
Oh, really?
Yep.
That's what will really make them dangerous.
Yep. Heart and lungs. If she won't have gotten far, there she is. She won't have a score, but... She got a sexy button, that's what matters. Every male moose in the neighborhood is mourning their loss today. They're going, oh man, she was fine. Yeah, I think the person who created these animals paid a little bit too much attention to their behinds.
Yeah, maybe they did.
Of course, I'm not a chest man, I'm more of a legs and behind man, so maybe I'm just noticing that fact because I'm a legs and behind man, But yeah, you almost got your first moose charge. I should have let her charge us just so you could see what it was like, but that would have, of course, gotten complicated with us trying to just get back to camp and get things taken care of.
Yeah.
There we go. Just in case. Because we're far enough out now that we could potentially run into another grazzly, so...
Yeah.
But yeah, he was walking along the side of the hill. Then he turned like he was going to come down the hill. Then he turned sideways again, and I decided I'd rather not take the risk. Otherwise, I'd have let him go. Because I have, you know, wow. No, I don't think he must be my second or third one. For a second there, I was thinking that that was my first grizzly, but I forgot I've actually taken a couple here.
Mm.
But so there you go, 9 o'clock moose up where that stand is. It's such a great place for moose, for reindeer, for roe deer, grizzly bars. Because if you're going to be a bar, be a grizzly, of course.
There you go.
And like I say, for me, it's nice when you walk back into camp before you log out. Simply because, like I say, the next time you log in, everything you were set up with will be in place. And since it's your pretty much standard setup for wherever you're going to hunt right now, until, you know, you pick up some other materials, it'll work out good for you, save you a little time. And for me, a hunt doesn't feel like I finished the hunt unless I return to camp. So.
Right. Is that what the music, the fanfare we just got meant?
Yep. You'll get the fanfare, and then at the bottom right, it'll say press I for inventory.
Ah.
And that shows you're officially back into camp. So there we go. And then what it does is it'll also allow you to do a exit if you want, because when you're actually in camp, you can hit F2 and see yourself.
Oh, okay.
So if we get over here by the fire. There we go. Now you should be able to hit F2 and have a view of yourself.
Ah, okay.
And you can record your outro or intro, depending on what you want to do.
All right. Well, I think we did quite an excellent hunt. Went very well.
Yep. If I look at you, it gives me your info. Confirmed 3 kills. Fantastic.
Excellent.
Score up to 7. And if you look at me, it should give you a little box in the upper right-hand corner of your screen. It should also say how many kills I made this hunt.
Okay, how do you... Oh, yep. 3 kills, confirmed.
All right, I was hoping to keep it even. The moose at the end evened us up, so...
Yep.
I took one reindeer, one grizzly bear, and one moose. And you took three caribou.
So we stuck... I was consistent, and you were varied.
Yeah, I'm glad I just didn't miss that one, because if I hit it bad, I'd have tracked it until I found it, and you can see it can get to be a bit of a hike.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I had an absolute blast, and I hope we can do it again very, very soon.
Well, I'm sure we will.
And I know you gotta get yourself some sleep.
Yeah.
I'm probably gonna go see if I can put a pointy stick in a T-Rex. I've been stood up 3 nights in a row here, so I'm hoping night number 4 is going to be the charm.
Well, good luck. I'm sure you'll get him.
Mm-hmm. I'm hoping, like I say, my new life's quest is to kill a T-Rex with one arrow. So,
if anybody can do it, it'll be you, I swear to God.
that last one, after I looked him over, the round from the 700 and the 2 rounds from the 44, they didn't have any effect. The round from the 700 actually hit him in the shoulder blade. The 2 rounds from the 44, one hit him in the arm, and one bounced off his nose. And so the 2 arrows I shot at the very end were the shots that killed him.
Wow.
So I'm close. I've taken the T-Rex using only 2 arrows.
You'll get it. You'll get
yep.
it. Alrighty. You take it easy.
Oh, I'll take it anywhere I can get it. And in the meantime, I got your back, brother.
Alright, I got yours. Bye-bye. Thank you.